Hello my friends, what's up, it's me Ronan and welcome back to OP Factions here on play.evopvp.net. As you can see here, I'm just standing outside the chest setup which we set up last time and it is working absolutely brilliantly. We've put the majority of stuff in there, not sure if we're going to keep it in this configuration, just showing you that it is still working and the chests have not burnt down, which is a good thing. But this is not the point of the episode. The point of the episode is that I would like to actually try a little bit of a concept. I've been thinking recently about how pretty much everyone's faction series is the same. You know, you sort of raid, you do PvP, and while that is all great and fancy, what I'd like to do every now and again is just do something that's just that little bit different. Something that's just sort of going to set myself apart from the rest just a tiny bit. So I got to thinking, I have a little bit of a habit here on factions of just going into the random teleport to try and find as many cave spider spawners as possible. So as you can see here inside Rustly Rose, if I just open up, you can see I am fairly good at it. 30 of them here. So I was thinking, could I find a way to sort of iron golem farm them cave spider spawners and sort of see if I can either MMO grind them or just sort of grind them for their drops? And I think this may or may not be a good setup. That's sort of what we're going to try and find out throughout today's episode. So each of these are going to represent a cave spider spawner. They're going to be up there a little bit. And the idea behind it is that they're going to spawn up there, drop down, and either die if I can find a way to keep it dark enough to sort of keep them spawning up there, but find a way to kill them down here just to get the drops, or sort of funnel them into a little shaft here, maybe a 1x1 drop or something, because we can just expand downwards, maybe take them down to one hit or something, maybe not, I don't know, and see if we can farm experience or MMO or something like that. It's sort of, I don't know how this is going to work out really, because all the stuff that I've done this series, you know, sort of the raiding and building the chest setup over there, it's all been pretty standard so far, and I know how it's going to sort of pan out. But this, I have no idea if it's going to work or not. On factions, the mob spawning rate is really low, so I reckon I'm going to have to use a fair number of these spawners in order to get a considerable amount. But it will also mean that there's just another thing going if I go in the AFK pool that Josh kindly built in the base. So while I'm in here, we can just have that going, funneling them in here. So if I go AFK for maybe 10 minutes or something, then we can just grind them all up and hopefully level up just a little bit. So I'm just going to see if I can build the structure of this. I'm maybe going to do some testing to see if I need to make these a little bit further apart. They do seem a little bit squashed in. Just see if this is going to work. So right now what I'm doing is just walling them all in. I'm going to do the double layer here in case somebody breaks in the wall with a wither or something. Just give them that little bit extra protection. Let's see if we can just hop up here. There we go. And I will be back with you guys when I have done a little bit more progress on this. Okay guys, so we have gotten the sort of initial structure and shape of it done. Not sure if I'm going to keep it or not, but I don't want to do any more in case we do need to change it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to fill the walls in with cobblestone, just for the time being in case we need to make any edits of it. And we are going to see if we can position these spawners in a way that they will work when we are in the base. I am interested to see this concept sort of works, because on factions, the mob spawning rate is really, really low. Whenever I go out to collect these sort of spawners, I only really typically get one or two cave spiders spawning, which is why I'm getting the idea of sort of more is better, basically. And I've got 30 here, so what's this? 4, 8, 12, 16. So I can essentially double the size of this. If we want that efficiency, whether we want the string or the XP, or if these leveling up on MMO sword thing still works. I'm not sure about that, but whatever it's going to be, it is sort of going to be helpful to us. Okay, so we are just about to begin placing these spawners. I'm probably going to just block that hole up there. Let's see how if this is going to work. There we go. They definitely seem to be working. So it is spawning the cave spiders, and I realised why I was taking damage, I've been poisoned! That one probably obviously wasn't light enough. That one appeared to... they're spawning in the walls. That's not good. This really isn't good. This has turned bad. This has taken a turn for the worse. Oh, I really miscalculated that. Okay, this is my Suktuk pick. This is what the tests are for. Boop. So, slight teething problems with this one, I'm going to have to say. Let me see if I can get this sorted out, and I will be right back with you guys. Okay, I may have found a solution. What I have done is I have added another layer here, and this is the torches here just going to simulate maybe lava or something. Something that's going to keep these conditions out here extremely bright, so that the cave spiders will hopefully prefer spawning in here, which will maximize efficiency. So what we're going to do is we are just going to have a second go at this, see if this works. Pop one down there. There we go. Oh, yep. There. Oh, gee, oh, this is going to work brilliantly. Oh, this is going to work amazingly. Okay. Yes. So hopefully, yep. There we go. If that's a sign of what things are going to be like, then I reckon this is going to be really good. One of the final progress updates here, and yes, I have placed the water at the back here. So the spiders are hopefully just going to fall down and then sort of gently glide along here. We're going to put in the water sort of troughs here, just when we're done, so that we can quickly just escape from here, because should just be able to ender pearl out of there. So what we're going to do is I am just going to quickly going to do come on, Ronan, use your words. What I'm going to do is I'm just quickly going to do this, and let's see how entertaining this is going to be. Oh god, no, no, no. Oh, this is all red. Jew! This is already going horribly wrong. I might need some help with this. Oh, if only I had friends to help me. Nope, no, god, that, wow. Oh, no, 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 no. There we go. Oh, no, no! Okay, I picked it back up. I picked it back up. You know what? Let's screw it. Let's have a golden apple. Let's try pillaring. Let's see if pillaring works better for us. Pillar, pillar, pillar. Pillar, pillar, pillar. Pillar, pillar, pillar. Okay, I think the question now is, how quickly can I spam these cave spider spawners? Okay, okay, don't make a mistake, don't make a mistake. No, no, I made a horrible mistake. Okay. Whoa, no, no. Oh, you can get up here now. That's not good. Not good for Ronan. Not good for Ronan. No, don't you dare, don't you dare. You can climb. Oh, so who thought spiders could climb? This, there we go. Oh, no, no. Okay. Ah! Okay, spammy, 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 spammy. Nope, 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 nope. You get down there. You get down there with your brothers and sisters. One, two, one, two. Tell you what, iron golems are never this annoying. Okay, break, 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 break. Oh, no, 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 this is really not going well for Ronan here. And why am I... Yeah, you know it's not going well when I refer to myself in the third person. Okay, so I have just got some hoppers and gonna see if this works. Okay, I will be right back with you guys, see if it works. Okay, go, 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 go. Oh, Jesus. Jeez Louise, I'm gonna have to do something about that. Yeah, I'm seeing a flaw in this plan. Yeah, I'm gonna have to put some iron bars or fences down or something to stop them climbing. Maybe glass panes. I've heard glass panes work. Okay, so I have actually drafted in a few reinforcements in the form of Josh. So what Josh is gonna do is he's going to help me. He's going to kill all the spiders in there so that I can build and sort of make the adjustments that we need to in order to make this as functioning as possible. Okay, you ready, Josh? Yeah, look at that face. That is the face of a ready man. Okay, so ready, we are going to take the final frontier. 3, 2, 1, and boom, in we go. Okay, here we go. As soon as we're in, all of this is, all hell's breaking loose. I'm actually going to take a gapple just to sort of get rid of the resistance here. Okay, gonna try and do the hoppers. Awesome, so those are the hoppers in place and they should be working fine. Everything should be getting funneled down to there, hopefully. Oh no, I just activated that. So what else we need to do is we just need to get the sort of glass panes set up here. So Josh, if you could would be ever so kind as just to get these spawns of Satan away from me, I can block up here and begin to place the glass panes. There we go. We're going to probably need more than 32 glass panes, in all honesty here, guys. But this will be a good start. There we go. Shibbity doopa, shibbity day. My oh my, what a wonderful day. Shibbity doopa, shibbity dee. My oh my, what a wonderful day. Oh, we just need one more set of glass panes and another layer. So that's a few more things. I reckon one more thing of glass panes will be enough. And I don't have an ender pearl to get out of here. Okay, Josh, I will be back in 1 second, okay? 1 second, Josh. And just turn all of them into glass panes. 48, yes, that will be plenty. Okay, and boop. Sorry about that, Josh. All your hard work just gone to waste. Okay, block up again. Hello. See if we can get this to work. Bop down a little bit. Yeah, we. Oh, thank God Josh is here. This would have literally been impossible without him. Of course, there will be a link to Josh's channel in the description just to say sort of a thank you to him for doing this. Come on, get away from me, you little spawns of Satan. In hindsight, probably should have built this beforehand. Thank you very much, Josh. And that should be it. Just regen a little bit. Can we block that? Yep, there we can. Oh, yes. So this should be... Oh, no, we still need to do the hoppers down there. Whoopsie doodles. Okay, so this seems to be stopping these spiders from climbing. There we go. Can I just get that final bit of hopper there? Yes, we can. Oh, yeah, so that this seems to be working fine as both an XP and item farm. Awesome. So thank you, Josh, for helping me out with that. Oh, it's much appreciated. Thank you for poisoning yourself there. So everyone go check out Josh in the description down below. He's been a massive help with all this. Oh, God, it would have been really, really awkward for me to have built this on my own. Well, anyway, guys, I reckon that's going to do it for today's video. If you enjoyed the video, then make sure to give it a like, because it really does make a difference. And if you're new to the channel and want to see more content like this, then make sure to subscribe in order to catch new videos. Well, anyway, guys, I'll see you next time. Goodbye, my friends. No, that went horribly wrong.